When I wake up, well, I know I'm gonna be the man who wakes up next to you. When I go out, yeah, I know I'm gonna be the man who goes along with you. If I get drunk, well, I know I'm gonna be the man who gets drunk next to you. And if I haver, yeah, I know I'm gonna be the man who's havering to you. But I would walk 500 miles and I would walk 500 more.
Morning announcements are coming at you.
Good morning, Ethel Lombard staff and students. It's Thankful Thursday. Thank you to our staff for your patience, for your flexibility, for the sacrifices you have made to help us accomplish the state test. Thank you to our students for your efforts, for overcoming probably different emotions you were experiencing every single day of the test. All of you probably experienced some different ones, and we probably had some similar ones that we were all experiencing. But I just want to thank you again for your adaptability. We know change is not always easy, and all of you worked with us to make sure that we could accomplish these tests. We do have some students making up tests today, so if you see a testing sign on doors, please make sure you keep your voice level to a zero. Please make sure you respect the learning environment, because remember, their score is our score, and we want every student to have the opportunity to be in an environment where they can perform their best. So again, please be observant. If there are students in the cafeteria area or the library, we will have students making up some of those tests today. Again, but I want to thank our students for helping us accomplish the IAR state test. I still want us to really have some conversations in our classroom around kindness. I have been disappointed this week, just some of my observations, some of the things I've heard, some of the things I've seen, where we are hurting one another, whether that be just words, whether it be actions, even through some of our jokes. So I want you to watch this video again, and more importantly, to have conversations around how can we have leaders emerge? How can we stop encouraging behaviors that are not kind? So let's take a look at this kindness video.
We're gonna have a kindness rap battle. So, this is how it's gonna work. Each one of them have to come up with a kindness idea. So, he could say, help somebody cross the street. You could say, pick up a piece of trash. The first person to stutter and be like, loses. Are you guys ready? First one.
Lend someone a toy.
Lend someone a toy.
Be respectful.
Be respectful.
Recycle.
Recycle.
Good toy.
Kindness takes a ton of bravery. When I was a little kid, when I was in kindergarten, there was this girl in my class, and her name was Christy, and every single day she would come to school wearing this necklace, right? And it was an important necklace. It was given to her by her great grandma. Well, one day we walked into a tiny lunchroom, much like your guys's, right? And she gets her lunch tray, she takes off her necklace, sets it down next to her lunch tray, begins to eat her lunch. And then the bell rang, it was time to clean up, so she cleans up her mess, throws her leftovers in the trash, turns around to walk outside to go out to recess. But right before she gets outside the door, she stops. And she feels her neck. Guess what she just did? She accidentally threw it away. And now she looks over the trash can and instantly she starts to what? She starts to cry. That she cared about this necklace so much that she walks over to that trash can crying, taking out piece of trash by piece of trash to find the necklace that her great grandma gave her. But then I saw this from across the way. I see that she's digging through the trash. So I walk over to help her. But right when I get about like 5 feet from her, I stop. And I think to myself, wait a minute. You see, if I help her, all my friends are gonna laugh and tease me for digging through the trash can. They're gonna make fun of me for doing something nice and kind to a girl. And so I had a choice. I could either do the right thing, something I know in my heart is the right thing to do, but if I do it, I'm gonna get made fun of. Or I could play it safe and walk away. So guess what I did? I ended up walking away. Was that really brave? Was that really nice and kind? No, you see, if you want to be a world changer, you have to be braver than I was when I was your age. So here's an important question that I'm going to ask you guys. How many of you sitting in this room right now would have helped her? Wow. There's some people out there that think kids like you can't change the world. Is that true? No. You see, the secret in order to change the world, it's not doing all these big, huge acts of kindness. It's about doing all the simple, small things every single day. If you guys want to be someone to make a massive difference in the world, then there's some important steps that you guys have to follow. The first step to change the world, everyone say this. Everyone say, start small. Now, step number two, everyone say, be brave. Step number three is the fun one. Everyone say, be kind. You guys have one mission every single day. Every single day, when you wake up and you look in the mirror, I want you guys to say this. I want you guys to say, today, I'm gonna make the world better than I did yesterday. The only thing that matters is by the time you lay your head to rest tonight, you can say that I made a difference. I made the world better than I did the day before. If you just do one simple act of kindness, trust me, our world will be a better place. Everybody say, we can change the world.
Thanks for practicing that breathing. And like I said, if you can practice breathing when you're not stressed, it can help you when you encounter stressful situations. I can hear music coming out of my printer. I wonder when it'll stop jamming. That's your joke of the day. It is time to celebrate some birthdays.
Happy birthday, happy, happy birthday. We celebrate your life today. We're glad that you were born today. What we don't need today, you know what we need, eh? Happy birthday, happy, happy birthday. We celebrate your life today. We're glad that you were born today. What we don't need today, you know what we need, eh? Happy birthday, happy, happy birthday. We celebrate your life today. We're glad that you were born today. What we don't need today, you know what we need, eh? Happy birthday, happy, happy birthday. We celebrate your life today.
And we hope you have an amazing birthday. And now let's hear what's on the lunch menu for today.
Lunch, it's time to munch, crunch, eat a bunch, it's time for lunch, not brunch,
I'm starving,
lunch.
On the lunch menu for today, it's spaghetti with meat sauce, a breadstick, fruit cocktail, steamed green beans, and your choice of white or chocolate milk. We have some IAR prize winners. Let's take a look. And we will be on Friday announcements announcing our cash prize winners. And remember, I wanted to make sure to get our makeup test students having opportunities to earn those X's so they can go in for those drawings. So let's take a look at our yesterday's testing IAR winners. Congratulations to those IAR winners. Please stop in the front office to receive your prize. I hope everyone has a wonderful Wednesday. And as always, Zephyrs, go be great.
Today is a new day. Today I promise to work hard, be kind, show pride, and celebrate who I am.
We are Lombard!
I love his message, but more importantly, I hope our students really take some time to reflect and talk about the ways that you can make Lombard a better place. Now let's celebrate some Lombard birthdays.